Welcome back to Horse Master with Julie Goodnight.
My name's James, and this is my mare, JJ. She's 11 years old, a quarter horse. I just started getting into horses about 4 years ago. My daughter, she's heavily into horses, and I just enjoyed being around her and the horses, so I took interest in this horse. When we got her home, we realized that she probably wasn't quite trained like we'd like her, and she's a little handful for somebody who's just getting started. So we've just been trying to work with her. Right now I'm trying to get her to where I can actually have a controlled ride with her when it comes to speed. I'd like to slow her down and be able to ride at a comfortable, more pleasurable gait. And we're just hoping that this time with Julie's going to help us out.
Well, this mare is certainly a lot of horse for James. He's a relatively green rider, and she doesn't have a real high level of training. She does have a lot of go. She's a pretty go-y horse, and that can be a lot of horse to manage. I think James is a pretty good rider. He's got a good solid foundation, but occasionally he's getting his spurs in this horse when he doesn't mean to be, particularly at the canter. And he's sometimes giving some mixed signals, so we need to work on that. Also, I think this mare is overbitted for her level of training and James's level of training and her tendency to be so go-y and rushy. I think that we can do better for her on a different bit. But I'd mostly like to work with James on improving his cueing, toning down his cues so that he's using more of his weight and seat to cue the horse and a lot less leg. This is a sensitive mare. She's looking for the go cue, and I think she'll respond a lot better just off a weight aid rather than the leg aid. Well, James, she looks like she's a bit of a turbocharged horse you got there.
Yeah, she is a bit of a turbocharge. She knows one speed, seems like.
Go, huh?
I'm hoping we could fix that.
Well, I think we can. Actually, I think there's a lot of things we could do. I'd like to change a couple of things up with her. I'd like to try a different bit that I think will help get her head down a little bit, get her in a more relaxed frame. The level of her head is a direct correlation to her speed and charginess. So the lower we get her head, the calmer she is. True of any horse. The higher headed they are, the more anxious they are. So we'll change up the bit. I'd like to get you cueing her more with your weight and less with, in fact, I'd like for you not to cue with your legs at all. I'd like to take the spur off her so that you can relax your leg a little bit. In order to make sure you don't keep the spur on or touch her with the spur, you're having to kind of stiffen your leg. Mm-hmm. And that stiffening causes your leg to actually bounce on the side. So it becomes counterproductive in the speedy horses. And you're occasionally hitting her with the spur when you don't mean to. And again, that's because your leg is tense holding the spur off her. Okay. So I'd like to actually get your leg in closer contact with her and get you cueing more off your seat. I think I can show you how to do that pretty well. Let's take her back to the barn, change up her bridle, get your spurs off, let me ride her for a few minutes, and we'll see what we need to do.
All right, looking forward to it.
Okay.
Stay tuned to Horse Master with Julie Goodnight.
Here's a quick tip about wearing spurs. Spurs are not a fashion statement, and they're not an appropriate tool for every horse and every rider. Spurs are an advanced aid for an advanced rider on an advanced horse, and they're not the best tool for working with a lazy horse. Before you make the decision to wear spurs, you should consult a trainer and make sure that you have adequate control over your leg so that you don't spur the horse at the wrong time.